Hi, my name is Ronnie Datta, and today we're going to talk about Skandagupta on Let's Talk About Bharat. Skandagupta was a Gupta Emperor of northern India. He was the son of the Gupta Emperor Kumaragupta I. His mother may have been a junior queen of Kumaragupta because Skandagupta's Bhittari pillar inscription lists the chief queens or Mahadevis of his ancestors, Chandragupta I, Samudragupta and Chandragupta II, but does not mention the chief queen of his father, Kumaragupta. The Bhittari inscription states that after restoring the fallen fortunes of his family by defeating his enemies, he visited his mother just like Krishna had visited his mother Devaki. Based on this description, some scholars have theorized that Devaki was the name of his mother. However, it is more likely that the description aims to highlight the degraded position of his mother, just like that of the legendary Devaki. Before Skandagupta restored her to a position of prestige and power, just like Krishna did for Devaki. Skandagupta ascended the throne in the year 136 of the Gupta era. He is said to have restored the fallen fortunes of his family. He spent a night on the bare earth and then defeated his enemies who had grown wealthy and powerful. After defeating his enemies, he visited his widowed mother whose eyes were full of tears from joy. The Junagarh inscription states that after his father's death, Skandagupta became the ruler of the earth by his own prowess. This suggests that Skandagupta acquired the throne using force. During Skandagupta's period, the Indo-Heptalites, also known as Huns, invaded India from the northwest, advancing as far as the Indus River. The victory against the Lechas happened in or before the year 136 of the Gupta era, when Skandagupta ascended the throne and when he appointed Parnadatta as the governor of the Saurashtra region, in which Junagarh is located. Since Skandagupta is not known to have fought against any other foreigners, these Lechas were probably the Huns. If this identification is correct, it is possible that as a prince, Skandagupta was sent to check the Hun invasion at the frontier, and Kumaragupta died in the capital while this conflict was happening. Skandagupta returned to the capital and overcame rebels or rival claimants to ascend the throne. There is also a lot of oral history on the terror of the Huns, and the defeat handed to them by Skandagupta has been passed on through generations. From Benaras to Gorakhpur up to Magadh, there are places named after those ancient battles, including Audhihaar, where the Huns were defeated, and Mundihaar, where many of the Hun army were beheaded. Compared to his predecessors, Skandagupta issued fewer gold coins, and some of these coins feature relatively less quantity of gold. It is possible that the various wars fought by him strained the state treasury, although this cannot be said with certainty. Skandagupta was most probably succeeded by Purugupta, who appears to have been his half-brother. Purugupta was a son of Kumaragupta I from his chief queen and therefore must have been his legitimate successor. It is possible that he was a minor at the time of Kumaragupta I's death, because of which Skandagupta ascended the throne. Skandagupta appears to have died heirless, or his son may have been dethroned by Purugupta's family. I hope you like this video about Skandagupta, and if you did, please share it with your friends, your family, subscribe to MyNation, and keep watching Let's Talk About Bharat.